हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर 3 ऑन स्टेट प्रो सॉफ्टवेयर। इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैड स्टडी सम बेसिक्स ऑफ दिस सॉफ्टवेयर। लेट अस रिकॉल इट फास्टली। फर्स्टली डू डबल क्लिक ऑन स्टेट प्रो बटन आइकॉन। स्टार्ट पेज ओपन। हियर वी कैन कॉन्फिगर आवर प्रोजेक्ट फाइल दैट इज बेस यूनिट, बेसिक डिज़ाइन कोड्स, बैकग्राउंड कलर, ओरिएंटेशन ऑफ ग्लोबल एक्सिस एक्सेट्रा, अप्लाई एंड सिलेक्टिंग। वी कैन मैनेज बैकअप, प्रेडिक्ट टाइम। लेट अस टेक इट एज 3 मिनट्स। क्लिक ओके। नाउ ओपन न्यू प्रोजेक्ट फाइल, सिलेक्ट द वर्किंग एरिया एंड नेम एंड डेस्टिनेशन ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट। नाउ सिलेक्ट द एड बीम एंड क्लिक ओके। द मेन यूजर इंटरफेस ओपन्स। नाउ हियर वी स्टार्ट मॉडलिंग। फर्स्टली जॉब इंफॉर्मेशन, क्लाइंट नेम स्टूडेंट, रेफरेंस ईएफओ बिल्डर, then now geometry using snap node, then now using geometry using snap node beam cursor, auto save pop-ups, click to save. Use escape button for complete the task. Now next section properties, define it and apply it using use cursor to assign. Shift N and Shift B to see node and beam number respectively. Now next support reaction is fixed support. Assign it. Now loading condition. Add dead load. Now define it. At self at UDL. Assign both of them. Use cursor to assign the property. नाउ एनालिसिस, रन एनालिसिस, गो टू पोस्ट प्रोसेसिंग, now we can see the node displacement and the reaction table. बीम मेंबर, शेयर फोर्स एंड बेंडिंग मोमेंट डायग्राम, इट्स स्केलिंग, नाउ एनिमेशन, now generate report, select the required entities from the input and output data. Click OK. Our output file generated. You can see this file. We can print it also. This is all we studied till now. Now again select the modeling tab. Today we will see some fundamental properties of this software. The use of Cartesian coordinate system to model the structure. And we will also see how to generate different support condition in structure by releasing its restraints. Firstly, undo all the data or delete all the data. Similarly, as before, set up job information, then geometry. Now today we will use Cartesian coordinate system to model our structure and add beam tool to create the beams by joining the nodes. Now, as we click on main screen, the toolbar get active. Select the Add Beam tool from there and join the nodes to create the beam. The first node of the beam is the starting point and the second node is the end point. Both are shown by green and red color respectively. Select beam cursor. As we bring beam cursor near to the beam, the start node and end nodes are shown as green and blue respectively. As for beam 4, similarly for beam 1. Now next, member properties. Create two rectangle sections of 100 cross 100 square mm and 200 cross 200 square mm. Let them Now we use new method of assigning property. As you can see, assign to selected beam button is inactive right now. To get it active, so now firstly select the definition property, then select the assigning member. Now assigning to selected beam buttons get active. Click assign to assign them property 1. Click yes. Similarly for property 2, we will do this again. By selecting these sections, the member have that property pop ups in red color, as you can see. We can also change the properties of member by just double clicking on the property in data area table. As we change 100 cross 100 square mm section to 120 cross 120 square mm, click change to apply it. Today we will create three supports: fix, roller and simply support. Just go to the create bar. First add fix support. Now use cursor to assigning supports. The cursor is changed for roller support and simply support. Change the view. Use pan tool from the toolbar to move main screen. As we can see, simply support and roller support. In roller support, the horizontal effects and movement are released. Similarly, for simply support, add node 5. The fixed end movement MZ acting perpendicular to the plane is get released. Now the next step is loading definition. Dead load primary. Dead load definition now. First one is self weight, vertical y direction, then UDL. Let us define a non uniform UDL. That is UDL acting on limited length of beam, right? Here D1 shows offset of UDL from the start node of beam, while D2 the length over which UDL act. Similarly, D3 for space frame. To double click on member to find the member property. As our member has 2 meter length, let us take D1 as 0.5 meter and also generate one more load as D1 equal to 0 and D2 equal to 1.5. Now assign it and let's see what happens. For self weight, we use another assigning method, that is assign to view. That is all members showing in the viewport get that property. After applying it, apply UDL. I use cursor to assign method. We can see the difference. Now to differentiate different loads in a group, the selected load definition on member pop-ups in blue color. While other loads in the same group are seen in green color. As we can see, for load condition 2, it's shown in blue while others are in green. So till now we did firstly job title, client name is student, reference file EFO builder, then modeling by Cartesian coordinate system and add beam tools for adding beams, then apply material properties, then different support conditions. Then load definition. Here we saw the use of cursor to assign the whole view. Then in UDL, non-uniform UDL, D1 and D2 significance. Now next is analysis part. As the previously added perform analysis command, we need not do it again, just delete it and run analysis from the menu bar. One error comes. As errors are not ignorable, so check it out where the error comes from the output file. Click on error. It shows density not provided, self add, command ignored. So we have to eliminate it first before processing. So go to the material property section. Here we had provided material property. So go to the state editor file and check out there. Here also we had given. So just refresh this file and open again. Again refresh the properties of material. And run analysis again. Error resolved. Warning can be ignored. Now we go to post processing. Here we can see the horizontal displacement of the node 5, that is roller support, while the simply support has no horizontal displacement. Similarly, we can see the reaction, the beam shear force and bending moment diagram. We can see the prop cantilever has no bending moment. Now just see the animation at roller support. Now generate report. Select the required output data. Then click OK. Okay. Now do some more changes in the structure and see its response on the structure and its member. Again, switch to the modeling tab. Let us add a concentrated movement loading at the start node of member 3. Click add button to dead load definition and add concentrated movement pointing z direction. D1 equal to 0. As we are putting it just start of the beam. Again run analysis and see the difference in response system. Here we can see the node 5 displays more as compared to previous example. It displays about 12.933 mm, while in previous example it displays about 8 mm. This is the bending moment diagram. Similarly, the animation. Similarly, we generate report as done before. It is section properties, beam displacement summary. This beam and force summary and reaction summary. It shows us axial shear, torsional bending moment all in one table. So that's all for today. In next lecture we will see different types of loads and structure editing tools. Thank you.